So sandwiched right between Orlando and Tampa, there is a city that has seen an insane population growth the past year, and not just with its population, but a ton of residential development, and it's becoming one of the most affordable cities for new construction and a quiet quality of life. Hey guys, this is Will with eXp Realty, and today we are here in Winter Haven, Florida. If you don't know where Winter Haven is just southwest of Davenport, right before you're heading over to Tampa and Lakeland, and it's really a cool city. I've had a lot of clients just from my Davenport video that were interested in this area as well, primarily because of the affordability, but I wanted to talk about some of the pros and cons of living in this area, because this might be the place for you and it definitely might not. I know there's people that go either way with some of the pros I'm gonna give and some of the cons. So let's hop right into it. Before we get started, make sure to click that subscribe button down below if you want to stay up to date with everything we have here coming in the Central Florida area. So let's go check out Winter Haven. For Winter Haven, which I think is the biggest pro and probably outweighs every single con I'm gonna list on this list, is going to be the affordability. Median sales price here in Winter Haven is right over $250,000. It's actually at $254,000. When you compare that to somewhere like Orlando, even Davenport and Tampa, those are sitting probably about mid threes right now. Orlando's at about 340, Davenport at 330, and Tampa's hitting that 330 mark as well. When you compare the prices, you're definitely getting way more bang for your buck here in Winter Haven. But outside of just resale homes, just the general market, I really like to focus on new construction because that's probably the biggest draw for people looking to move to Winter Haven. So the cool thing about new construction homes here in Winter Haven is that for under $350,000, it buys you a lot. And when I say a lot, I mean, when compared to what you can get in the markets I work in, Orlando and Tampa, you're saving a lot of money. Some of the $300,000 homes are definitely running you anywhere from $450,000 to $600,000 in these two other cities. So that's why it's been such a big draw for people, because you're getting these beautiful brand new homes with a ton of space, a ton of size, paying literally almost half the price that you'd pay in these other metropolitan areas. There's a ton of really great builders out here. You have D.R. Horton, Meritage, Richmond American Homes, just to name a few. And the good thing about it is, because $350,000 or even more or less is a lot more in this area than it is in those other markets, you're getting a lot more upgrades in the homes. One of the gripes I have, even in Orlando, is a D.R. Horton home in like a Claremont or Leesburg area isn't gonna give you the same updates they're gonna give you here for the exact same price, which is obviously because of the location. So you get a really, not only do you get these big, beautiful homes, but on top of that, you're getting a lot of updates and upgrades in them that you're probably not gonna get for the same price in other markets. Another really cool thing about Winter Haven is it does qualify for USDA, and that is the zero down loan program, if you are not aware. So you can buy a home here for zero down, and as long as you're staying under their cap limit, which is about $362,000, you can get a home for zero down, which is really, really cool, because a lot of markets here in Central Florida is getting few far in between to find. So that's a really good thing that kind of ties into the affordability. Then we get into the taxes. Because there isn't a crazy, crazy development boom here, even though developers are fighting for residential land, the taxes are not crazy here either. So you're honestly, from down payment to your monthly payment and your mortgage, you're saving a ton of money living here in Winter Haven. So pro number two for me is going to be the location, but this is also kind of is also going to be another con. So it's going to be con number one. So con one and pro two is going to be your location. The good thing about this is you are right in this I-4 corridor. So you're right in the middle of Lakeland and Davenport. So you're really only about 20 minutes from Davenport, and you're only about another 20 minutes from Lakeland. So you're right in the middle there. To Tampa, you're not about another 30, 45 minutes. And then back to Orlando, you're about another 35, 45 minutes as well. So you're not super far away, but you're also not super close. So some people like that. Once again, you are a little bit further out, which is kind of ties into the affordability and why it's more affordable. However, you know, if you are someone that likes, you know, to be close to a metropolitan area, super, super close, and you don't want to do that commute, that's probably not going to be the best place for you, just because, like I said, it's not super far, but it's also not super close. I know some people like myself like to be in the heart of a city where there's a ton of stuff going on, but you're not going to get that here in Winter Haven. But other people like being pulled back and farther away from all the noise, which you definitely get here because it's a really, really quiet city. So location is also going to be a pro and a con, just because it can really go either way depending on what you prefer. Another pro for me is going to be the nature. Winter Haven is very, very rich in nature. So if you are a nature lover and you love parks, trails, and especially lakes, there is a lot of lakes here. and Lakefront Living, this would definitely be the place for you because there's such an abundance of it. And while they are getting residential development, they're not really sacrificing any of that nature. While I did see a ton of communities as we were going through, and just from the clients that I've shown here before, there is a ton of brand new communities. You really can't tell too much because you still have all of that nature there. It's not compromising all the new development and homes that are coming. So you kind of have best of both worlds, which is really, really cool. So con number three, I'm in my last con for the day, is going to be the things to do. I did say you are a little bit further away from Orlando and Tampa. So the downside of that is if you're a person that likes nightlife and all these fun things to do, like different attractions, shopping centers, all of that, unfortunately Winter Haven does not have that. I'm not gonna lie to you, there's not a rich supply of it that's like super, super enjoyable. So I think definitely if you're a person that enjoys kind of that slow down, relaxed life and you don't need that stuff, you don't mind driving to it, this would be great. However, if you want it to be right there, you're gonna have to go somewhere else for it because unfortunately as of right now, they don't have it. But I will say with all the future development that we're coming to the I-4 corridor here, it's gonna come, but it's just not here right at the moment. So my last pro for today, which is gonna kind of sum up this video, is the future and the development of this area. Any person that invests in real estate like myself, or that you even in real estate in any form in Central Florida, is going to tell you that this I-4 corridor between Tampa and Orlando is the future of Central Florida. You're in between two mega cities, and honestly, developers are fighting left and right for land here so they can build and develop here. So right now it's primarily residential, but the commercial side is coming. So here in Polk County, we've actually seen almost a 30% increase in equity just in the past year because of all that new development that I mentioned earlier. So in terms of affordability, it's still time to get in early. And if you have the foresight, because foresight is always better than hindsight, you're gonna make a really, really strong investment here because of everything they have coming here. Once again, it's people start to get pushed out of Tampa and Orlando because those areas are becoming more and more unaffordable for people. They're starting to come here, so what they can afford here is a lot more, it's a lot nicer, and there's a ton of development here. So if you're looking to make a very smart investment and you don't mind the commute overall, I would say that this is a great place to live. But you definitely have to have foresight, because you come here right now, you might be like, oh, well, I don't see it. But you definitely have to see the development that's coming here, because this area is going to grow a ton, and it's already been growing rapidly just in the past 2 years alone. So investment-wise, I don't think you can beat this kind of area, Winter Haven, Lake Alfred, Eagle Lake. I don't really think you can beat this area at all, to be honest with you. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that super quick video I did about the Winter Haven area. It's a very nice place. There's a lot of nature, a lot of new development. I love showing clients here. I have a lot of clients that want to live here. So I decided let's cover it for a video, just so you can get all those questions answered before you decide to make that move. So if you guys like that video, make sure to click that subscribe and that like button so I can bring more of this content to you. And if you're looking for a realtor in the Central Florida area, I'd love to be your realtor of choice. Catch you guys next time.